Okay, welcome to Introduction to R. R is a statistical programming language. This is a series of lectures and this is just introduction part. So what is R? R is a computer programming language. It's open source for statistical computing and has very good graphics. It's open source and with packages contributed by many users. And it works on Windows, Mac and Linux. So any kind of operating system you can run it on. And it's also script based and not GUI based, so the advantage is you can automate processes over like large number of machines. It's effective in data handling and storage facility and a large integrated collection of tools for data analysis. It's large and highly flexible collection of graphing facilities for data display. And it's a well-developed, relatively simple programming language. In fact, it is a very advanced programming language compared to the other languages. We'll see that in later lectures. And R was started by Ross Ihaka and Robert Gentleman in 1993 in New Zealand. And R language is a programming language you write your commands in. And before R, there was a language called S from Bell Labs in 1976. And R is better than SPSS. And only thing is, it doesn't have as much support, corporate support. You have to depend on the internet and R users for any kind of questions you have. So the packages that we have for data analysis are SAS, IBM SPSS, Tata, Excel, MATLAB for engineers, and open source we have R and Python. So R is used by statisticians and Python is by developers. MATLAB is used by engineers. And SAS is used by businesses. And Stata is used by social science. Microsoft Excel is used by almost all office users. So what is not R? R is not fast like C++ or Python. And there's a limit to the amount of data that can be processed. So you can say it's for medium and small data processing. For large data you need C or Java or Pascal. Not Pascal, a Python. And there's a very steep learning curve. And debugging is difficult. So it's important that you know R well before you write any R code. What about Excel? Excel allows quick prototyping, data is easy to manipulate, there's no concept of missing data, so everything is there, what you see is all the data. But you can see what is happening, the graphics are poor, the colors are like fixed, you can't write for loops unless you know Visual Basic, even then it's like not easy. Statistical packages are there, but there's no guarantee the accuracy and the functions they use and what are the defaults. It's inflexible if you don't agree with the defaults. And many things are not possible in Excel, but most people get by. And if the results are wrong, nobody notices it. What are the strengths of R? It's a comprehensive set of statistical techniques. It has classical tests, statistical tests, linear and non-linear modeling, time series, cluster and classification, spatial analysis, Bayesian statistics, and almost all the techniques are already in R or available as a package. So what are the strengths of R? It is completely open source, users can add packages, you can edit existing R functions, it's free, there's a lot of people using it, scientists and good people. From the quality of R code you can see that. It's easy to replicate your work from data to the finished product. You don't have to just look at Excel chart and say, okay, I have to believe it. You can actually run the data to see that actually the graphs are matching the data that you have. And the output is really good quality. Graphs are really high quality. It makes it much better than what you'd expect from anything else with minimal effort. So the R is a programming language. It's very steep to learn, but it's very rewarding if you know it well. You have to be patient and creative. And you need to look on Google whenever you're lost. And lots of online help files are there. The help files are somewhat dense, but they're comprehensive. And books are also there, but almost all books get outdated unless they're written by the developers of the R language itself or R packages. And many of the books are outdated, so you have to be careful on which books you get. So installing R, you can just Google for it, download the 32-bit, 64-bit R as your Windows or Mac or Linux might be. And always install as admin and stuff because we can't really deal with permission problems. Really, this is not a place to worry about those small things. Install R and RStudio. RStudio is just a GUI for looking at controlling the R package nicely. So So what's the workflow now? You read the data and analyze the data, make some graphs, and you draw conclusions from the data. That's the general workflow in R. It can be automated also. We'll look at that later. So how do you start R? You find R program, run it, and then you enter commands at the command prompt. The greater than sign blinking cursor is a command. You can type some variable x equal to 7, 2 plus 4, x plus 19, and R will reply with the evaluating the result. 2 plus 4 will be 6, like that. So you have R command prompt, and then your hash starts a comment line. You type comments and you get some on numbers and equations, you get some output expressions, and that's the data. And one stands for the as a vector of size 1, because in R everything is a vector at some point. And what is R doing? R is basically evaluating the results, and then less than minus actually means assignment. It means to assign 7 to the variable x, and in this case 19 plus x is 26. And if you, and it's case sensitive, so if you use the wrong case, capital X, it says object x not found. So first thing you notice is everything is an object, anything unknown is an object, so everything is an object in R. So it's highly object oriented modern language, and you can use it like a calculator. So you, in RStudio, you're typing stuff out here. And here the variables that you are defining are variable and values are listed out here. And here are the plots of the graphs that you see out here. X, Y, Z and whatever values. You can use it like a scientific calculator. You just type in the expression, you get the answer. But it has slightly more. It has undefined numbers and infinite numbers. So 1 by 0 is infinite. And 0 by 0 is not a number. It has complex numbers also, like square root of 2i is 1 plus 1i. It's a complex number, so ultimately it converts to complex numbers as the need may be. So let's look at some simple commands in R. So you can have expressions, exponentiation, square root, multiplication with parentheses, and it follows the usual Bodmas rule, multiplication before addition and stuff. Exponentiation to the e raised to 1 is 2.718282, and log to the base 2 gives you back 1, and you can even do. So a lot of functions take optional arguments, named arguments. So you can say I want log of 10 to the base 10, and base is a parameter name. So it, because the function has a lot of parameters, we can just name them. Instead of, you don't have to assign all the parameters, just the ones that you're interested in. In this case, you want to change the base to 10. And if you don't complete the expression, you leave it, press new line, the plus sign comes. That means it's expecting a prompt for more input. So you can continue typing on the next line. So question is, like, we'll skip the questions. You can try this doing exercise later on in class. And then references are Venables and Smith, Introduction to R. It's available online. And basic statistics tests in R from stat methods is there. Advanced probability statistics in R by Zunkind. It's a blog, and you can find a lot of, he's really done a good job of it. And motor statistics test in R at UCLA. It has a bunch of things. And 7 lectures on financial trading with R. And R for traders. Thank you. We'll look at more stuff later in the next lectures.